Hi students, how are you all? I hope all are well. Okay students, so welcome to Science Bridge Course class. So in the last class we discussed about chemical bond. Okay, so in that there is two types of chemical bond, ionic bond and covalent bond. And also learn what are the differences between covalent and ionic bond. Okay. So today we discuss about metals and non-metals. In that, what are the physical and chemical properties of metals and non-metals, and what are the uses of metals and non-metals. Students already studied in 8th standard. Okay students. So students, now let's know about their properties. So first we know about the physical properties. The first property of metal is its malleability. By this property, the metals can be beaten into thin sheets. Non-metals does not show this property. Next property is conduction of heat. Metals are good conductor of heat and electricity, while non-metals are poor conductors. The property of metal by which it can be drawn into wires is called ductility. It is the third property of metals. Non-metals do not show ductility. Now let's talk about another property of metals, that is sonorous. Metals produce ringing sounds when they struck, so are said to be sonorous. The materials other than metals are not sonorous. So students, by these properties we can say that metals are hard, lustrous, malleable, ductile, sonorous and good conductors of heat and electricity. Examples, iron, copper, aluminium, calcium, magnesium, etc. are the examples of metals. Non-metals like coal and sulfur are soft, dull, non-ductile, non-sonorous, non-malleable and poor conductors of heat and electricity. Sulfur, carbon, oxygen, phosphorus, etc. are the examples of non-metals. Students, after discussing about physical properties of metals and non-metals, let's as know about their chemical properties. Metals like iron, copper, magnesium, etc. react with water and make their oxides. These oxides are basic in nature. Now we talk about the non-metals. Sulfur reacts with oxygen, giving the sulfur dioxide gas. Oxides of non-metals are acidic in nature. Another chemical property of metals is reaction with water. Most metals react with water vigorously or slowly. Sodium is stored in kerosene oil due to its high reactivity nature with air. Non-metals do not react with water. Highly reacts with atmospheric oxygen, so it is stored in water now. Now let's know about the reactions of metals and non-metals with acids. Metals react with acids and produce hydrogen gas, while non-metals do not react with acids. Students, you will be surprised to know that like acids, metals also reacts with bases and produces hydrogen gas. Non-metals react with bases complexly. Besides these chemical reactions, metals also show the property of displacement reactions. We can see a displacement reaction here, in which one metal is displaced another metal from its compounds. Okay, students. Till now we have learned that what the physical and chemical properties of metals and non-metals. And now let's move on another important topic, that is, what are the uses of these metals and non-metals? As we know that metals are hard in nature, so they are used in making machinery, automobiles, aeroplanes, trains, satellites, industrial gadgets, cooking utensils, water boilers, etc. Next, non-metals are not so hard, so they are used in fertilizers, water purification process, life supporting air crackers and purple color solution, as an antiseptic on wounds. Okay, students, I hope all are understand. Okay, next class I will come with new topic. Okay, thank you.